On this video, we do the following six problems. Learning how to write a function is a composition of two other functions. This is part 8 of functions. We're going to learn how to write a function as the composition of two other functions. For example, let's say we had f of x equals to x squared minus 6 and g of x was equal to square root of x. Remember, if we wanted to do g of f of x, that means g of f of x, right? We could write it that way. And now f of x is x squared minus 6, so I plug that in for f of x. And then I go to the g function, which is the square root, and I'm going to replace the x here with the x squared minus 6. So I have square root of x squared minus 6. So when you look at this composite function, now the question is, could we go backwards? If somebody told me I had some function, I'll call it h of x with square root of x squared minus 6. Could you sort of go back and figure out, if you knew what f of x and g of x was up here, that this really is the same thing as g of f of x? So that's what we're going to try to figure out. Well, how would conclude that? If you look at h of x, you say, hey, it's the square root of something. So it looks like the main function here at the end is the square root of something, and that is g of x. So that's a clue that it's probably g of something else. And then underneath the square root is that something else. All right, so what's underneath the square root is x squared minus 6. That happened to be f of x. So that's a way to go backwards. So let's try it on something else. All right, so we take these three functions. F of x equals 5x, g of x equals square root of x, and h of x equals x squared minus 3. We're going to try to write each of these functions below as a composition using either f, g, or h. Okay, so there's only two of them. So how could I write the square root of x squared minus 3? So I look up here. I've got three functions. And the main thing is I have the square root of something. So this looks like it's a square root of x, but instead of x, I have an x squared minus 3. So the trick here is to say, this is really g of x squared minus 3 because it's the square root of x squared minus 3, g of x with square root of x. All right, now, what about x squared minus 3? What is that? Well, I look back up here, and oh, that's h of x. So this is really g of h of x. Takes a little practice. You might try that again on your own. All right, let's look at this next one. This looks like it might be a little bit trickier. So we have 25x squared minus 3. And I look up there and I see, which one does this look most like? This looks kind of close to h of x. See, it's got the x squared minus 3. It's got something minus 3. All right, so we have to look up here. This isn't really just h of x because it's not the x that's being squared. I've got a 25x squared. So I have to think, what is that that's being squared? That's the same thing as 5x squared minus 3. All right, so now when we look at it this way, it's, 5x. That's f of x. So what you can do is say, well, the overriding thing, it looks like it's h of something. If you want to break it down into two steps, it looks like it's h of 5x. Okay, convince yourself if you put 5x in place of x up here in the h function, you would have this 25x squared minus 3. But what is 5x? And we look up here, 5x was f of x. So this is h of f of x. These are challenging problems, definitely. Don't expect to get them right away. Okay, let's do the next one. So we have 5x squared minus 15. I don't see anything that looks quite like that up there, but you might notice that it's closest to this, it looks like an x squared minus 3. So let's see. If I factor this, maybe that'll help me see it. So this is 5 times x squared minus 3. Okay, now when I write it in that form, now does it look like something that's up here? And it looks like 5 times something. So it looks like it's the f function up here, right? It's 5 times something. In this case, 5 times x minus 3. So 5 times something is f of something, and it's f of x squared minus 3, because that's what the 5 is multiplied by. And then x squared minus 3, oh, that was h of x. So this is f of h of x. These are pretty challenging to do, and don't expect to get it right away. You might want to go back and try these again, but let's see if you could do a couple more on your own. All right, we're going to take the same three functions for f, g, and h, and I'm giving you three problems to try here. So put the video on pause and see if you can work this out on your own. All right, let's look at the first one, square root of 5x. All right, looks like the overriding thing is the square root of something. That looks like a g of something. So this is g of, g of x means the square root of x, so I'm taking the square root of 5x. So this is g of 5x. Okay. And then, oh, 5x is just f of x. So this is g of f of x, so I could write this as g of f of x. I've written as a composite function now. Right, x minus 3. That looks like the h function. It looks like something minus 3. It's something squared minus 3. So that is a little bit tricky. You have to think, what squared is going to give you that x? And that's the square root of x squared. Tricky. So this is an h function, but it's the h of square root of x, because notice square root of x squared would just be x. Okay? And you'd have that thing, the square root of x squared minus 3, which is x minus 3. Okay. And now what is the square root of x? That's g of x. So this is h of g of x. Last one. 5 times the square root of x. Okay, you look up there at the functions. That looks like 5 times something. Okay, so that's the f function. And it's 5 times square root of x, right? So, square root of x is g of x. So this is just really f of g of x. These are pretty challenging problems, all of the problems I've done in this video. So I'd suggest you take and try them again.